What's up, guys? We're back at it again. Take 3, 4. Now it's cool enough that the phone should be turned off. Look at that window on. The grand finale.
Alright. Hey, I had a question for you, boss.
Yeah.
Did the dogs do that, or did you?
Yeah, they did that.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And that's the dirt right there, or did they relocate it somewhere?
Yeah, when they dig, it seems like it disappears.
It's crazy. I thought the Indians came and got it. Like,
no.
That's a lot of dirt.
I'm not sure who put the hose down there.
I put it there because that's why I watered earlier because of the...
Thank you, yeah, because the angle was off.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the dogs have been doing
that's
that.
That's crazy, man, because, yeah, when I serviced it, I was like,
They've been chasing some mice. I think
saw one yesterday.
They caught one.
Did they?
They caught one yesterday.
Really? That was the one then. That was the one. It was right here. It came out and it went under the fence.
Where did it come out from?
It was right over here. It was
somewhere over here.
Being racks in her walls, and they die in her wall, you know, and then she got a big knocked down drywall to find out which wall it was in, but she could never figure out where they were going to be in it. They patched every hole everywhere, but it was the dryer problem. That's what I'm thinking, because after that happened to us, I was like, yeah, I don't know, check your dryer vent, you know, get a screen around it.
Yeah, with these guys digging, I've been thinking about I wonder if I put like some river rocks underneath there, so they can't keep doing that.
Okay. Could I wouldn't recommend it because in the winter months the bougainvillea it'll freeze beyond repair, it'll kill it because the roots are exposed. Yeah,
okay,
and those roots are exposed right now. Yeah, anytime you have air roots like that, it's not good.
I was thinking about doing something similar over here though, at least along the fence, kind of like what you got with these rocks.
Yeah, and back there because I dug up a bunch and I kind of put them, you know, I just tried to do something with them to get rid of them, but yeah, if you wanted to, whatever.
Because
I can lift it up, you know, I can lift it up, put, you know, so much dirt back in, and then just do a little light retention around it, you know, with the river rock, if you like.
Just kind of discourage them,
yeah. Well, because, yeah, they're not going to want to pick up a rock and like that, you know.
Yeah.
I think they just dig, and they dig, and they dig, and the thing is, this soil is so expansive that they just, you know, they push it right down. It's real sandy.
Oh, yeah, if they find a little pocket where it's real sandy.
I think they're trying to cool off.
I read some stuff because I'm trying to figure out how to get them to stop. One of the things it said is that.
Yeah.
They got so much grass.
The whole time. house real well. Ooh, there's a bird. We gotta get that picked up for the dogs again. Because, yeah,
that would make a dog sick. Oh, wow.
Yeah, we tried to keep it from that, but
yeah,
there was no way to...
Trimming the tree, I'll knock them down.
Yeah. Well, they were in here.
That's crazy.
They did a little mess in here.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah, we have a little bit under our porch. We just have one little spot where there's actually more place for them to nest. I just put a block in it. Yeah, they always want to nest in the house, but usually they'll check there first before they go to a tree. And then they'll just post up in a tree. Yeah. I think they die anyway because the wind and then the landscapers come and trim the trees.
Yeah,
every time I do that, I look down, I'm like, oh shit, there's 40, like, the bird was like opened the egg, it was like after the other Sabrina. I'm like, ah, this is horrible, man. You know what I mean? I was just like, ah.
Next time, let me know I got my beef fryer on
the floor. Hey, quail, I'll mess with some quail all day.
You know what I'm saying? Exactly. You know what I'm talking about, though.
Oh, yeah.
Just fry the whole thing.
Oh, yeah.
Let me know if you anything, man. Did you try the chili out?
No, I mean, I try not like things like that. I'm like, oh, because I have a DirecTV receiver, but I actually haven't watched TV in 2-3 years because I just, you know, haven't ordered a remote. You know, I just, you know, I don't know. I used to watch TV a lot, but.
No, I know what you mean.
I'm
going
to turn it on when I get home, though, because I use it to listen to music. I use it to put out my high frequency music because I have a signal going to the subwoofer, and I use it to make sure I can listen to sound.
That's cool.
But yeah, I'm definitely going to look forward to hooking up the DVD player and actually watching something. I had an old school TV, right? Old
dusty.
It was so dusty. It was a fire hazard. It caught on fire. You know what I mean? Swear. Oh, that's perfect. It fit right in place, too. Right on the dresser. It's perfect. Like, appreciate it, man.
Yeah.
I like LG products, you know?